With that breaking news tonight, just moments ago, authorities said a nearly two-day-long standoff ended with an armed confrontation in St. Michael. A man who was barricaded inside a home was shot and airlifted to the hospital. This happened just about 30 minutes northwest of the Twin Cities, impacting an entire neighborhood and town. It started as a 911 call about a gun complaint. Devon Rahming's been watching the situation for hours and joins us live now. Devon?
Well, Julie, people in this neighborhood are going to be able to sleep a lot better tonight now that this standoff situation has been brought to a close. In fact, we just heard a loud round of applause from some of the people who have been out here standing by, watching everything unfold, applauding the officers and deputies that responded to this scene. Now, as you mentioned, that suspect was shot and airlifted moments ago to a hospital, and his condition at this time is unknown. But as you can see behind me, this is still a very active scene. There have been officers and deputies from several different agencies across the metro helping out with this task. And people who live in this neighborhood that we spoke with earlier this evening, they shared with us what they saw and heard during those frightening initial hours.
People passing through this St. Michael neighborhood Wednesday evening were met with roadblocks.
Pretty quiet now.
And turnarounds as Wright County deputies spent nearly 48 hours trying to negotiate with a 39-year-old man held up in a home. Neighbors say they heard countless gunshots just after midnight Tuesday.
We lost track after 30 minutes. I mean, it was just nonstop gunshots all through the night.
Deputies say several rounds of those shots were fired at them from the suspect.
No deputies or officers have been injured as a result of these shots.
The suspect, who we're not naming because he hasn't been formally charged, has an extensive criminal history with active warrants for domestic assault and is a convicted felon.
Well, I know somebody that knows him. I doubt he's gonna surrender peacefully. And we know what that means.
Officers and child protection workers have been called to the home several times, according to court documents, and officers say the suspect is armed with guns, thousands of rounds of ammunition, body armor, door breaching equipment, and what one officer called a doomsday room, stating it was one of the most toxic environments I have ever seen children raised in.
Now, we're told the area around the suspect's home will remain secured as investigators recover evidence and piece together what took place here nearly 48 hours ago. We're also told that there were three children in the home and a woman. They were removed from the home safely and evaluated by EMS. Of course, this is a developing situation, and investigators will be out here for the next few days trying to piece together everything that led up to this. And we'll be sure to bring you any updates right here on air and online. Julie.
All right. Thank you, Devon.